In this video, we bring words to life. I explain how I used After Effects and our plugin Pastiche to morph 5 paragraphs of text into a dragon head. It's an animated Calligram concept that works with any logo or image. We'll look at tips to keep control over the animation and perfectly integrate the result onto a book page. First of all, you need a text. Here, I used an AI to create it quickly because there are specific constraints. While the content is up to you, the structure is dictated by technical constraints. To stay under the 1,000 layer limit and ensure fluidity in After Effects, I chose to create 7 paragraphs of 100 to 300 characters each. We will only animate 5 of them, with the other 2 serving solely as decoration. Feel free to adjust this as you see fit. Start by creating a 1080 by 1920 pixels page in Illustrator. Then paste the text into the document. Opt for the Times font and modify the title to make it much larger. Next, convert the text to vectors using the Create Outlines function. Since the idea is to animate only the central paragraphs, be sure not to select the first or last block, or the title. Choose the Direct Selection tool, select these elements, cut them, and paste them onto a new layer. To transfer this to After Effects, you have 2 options. Either use the Overlord extension for simplicity, or use the native method with Illustrator layers as follows. Note that importing will be the longest step, as After Effects takes a moment to process the files or shapes. Setting up Pastiche, however, will be very quick. Select all the elements on the layer, open the menu, and choose the Release to Layers sequence option. Illustrator places each letter on a separate layer, allowing you to move them out of the parent layer. Delete the latter once it is empty. You now have a layer for the paragraphs and independent layers for each letter. Save the document as Dragon Layers. Heading to After Effects. Import the Dragon Layers file as a composition and make sure to choose layer size. You may have to wait a few moments during this process. Once the layers are loaded, import the dragon image, place it in the composition, and switch its blending mode to overlay. Then mask the unnecessary parts to keep only the essentials. Display only the layer with the title and the reference paragraphs. Center its anchor point, then position it and adjust its scale. Pre-compose it and name the composition Source. Since Pastiche only needs the black outline, add the Set Matte effect. Check Invert Matte and select Luminance. The dragon is now outlined on a transparent background, ready for animation. Back in the main composition, lock the layer with the title, here Layer 1, so Pastiche doesn't touch it. Apply the plugin to the source layer and hide it. One click on Create, and Pastiche generates a first collage. Undo to return to the original state, an essential step to reset the layers after a preview. Remember that Pastiche can transform position, scale, rotation, opacity, and color. Change the distribution mode to stippling for a more interesting look. Since the letters seem a bit too big, set the scale to random instead of from neighborhood, and define values between 5 and 15. The result is better, but to refine it further, reduce the min and max scale values. Finally, disable prevent overlap to make the dragon denser, like the original. That's not bad. Let's undo again. Oops, I correct the forgotten undo. And we can continue. For rotation, choose random with values between negative 45 and 45 to match the look of the original video. Okay, perfect. Time for animation. Pastiche offers several options, such as keyframe forcing or frame intervals, but here we will use layer markers. Place a marker at frame 50 and another one at frame 175. If you click Create now, Pastiche creates a transition between 2 collages, which causes us to lose the original text position. Since the goal is to start from the initial position, undo this action. Let's configure Pastiche correctly. Place the cursor on the last marker, enable animation for position, scale, and rotation in transform. Then go back to the first marker and select Use Previous Value to create keys from the initial state. By clicking Create, the transformation happens and the text nicely morphs into a dragon. Let's undo once again. Since the animation is too linear, change the temporal interpolation to ease in and out before recreating the animation. The layers now benefit from easing at the start and end. To desynchronize the movement, add an offset of 50. The animation keys no longer all start at frame 50, but are staggered in time, both at the beginning and the end. The result looks nice. It is also possible to define two different values for the offset. For example, 50 at the start, and a larger value of 100 at the end. To break the linear path of the objects, use custom spatial interpolation with values negative 20 and 20. One click on Create to see the result. The animation matches expectations. The only downside, the punctuation is too big. Select all punctuation characters and delete their scale keyframes. Here's our dragon animation. Let's move on to the final integration on the book page. In Photoshop, since the image I had chosen contained text, I selected the page to clear it using Generative Fill. The Flux Context Pro model gave the best result. The lighting effects and shadows are perfectly preserved, making the scene very realistic. So here's the book with a blank page. Import this image into After Effects, create a composition to place it in, and define the framing as well as the desired orientation. Drag the dragon composition into this new scene, position it correctly, and adjust the levels to match the black of the text with the ink of the book. The integration is complete. Let's watch the final result. Different shots, close-ups, or in 3D were created from this composition to edit the final animation. Check the description for links for inspiration, and don't forget to subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Feel free to ask if you have any questions.